few months ago, I made a short about recycling half-used candles. And my sister, who lives on the other side of Canada, really liked that idea. So I'm mailing her some wicks, and this is a step-by-step tutorial on how to make really nice candles from some that might not look so nice anymore. I'm Anna. How about we get our supplies together? You're going to need wicks. These ones come with stickers, so it's really easy to stick on. But I've seen people use like hot glue. That works too. But the stickers are really convenient. And you're gonna need something to hold your wick in place. I have a wick holder, which works great on circular objects, but you can also use a skewer and just wrap your wick around the skewer. I also sometimes just use two skewers and just support the wick this way, just like kind of between two skewers. That also works too. Then you're going to need some sort of container. You can use any container. I have some glass ones. You can use mason jars. I really like the idea of this coffee container. It's metal and I think it would make a really cute, like, I don't know. I just think this would be cute. So I am definitely going to try this. And then you will need a pot or a pan. And you want it to be shallow enough that you can grab your candle out after it's melted without like burning your fingers from the hot water. So I thought I originally wanted maybe something a bit thicker, but I find this pan works perfect. And I did pick it up at a thrift store because I don't want to use any of my own pans. And of course, you're going to need your candles, the ones that you're going to be melting down. And you're going to need some oven mitts and some sort of towel or mat and tweezers or pliers to pull out the old wick once you've melted down your wax. Let's make some candles. First, I'm going to set my wicks. And I ordered these wicks a while ago off Amazon, and they are pretty thin. And they're more for like tea lights, but this is what I have and this is what we're gonna use. But don't order these ones, order thicker ones. Your candle will burn more evenly and it'll look nicer. But I have these ones and this is the container I'm using. So I'll be using 5 wicks just to get my candle to burn. And the nice thing about these wicks is they just have little foamy stickers that you just stick on the bottom and then stick to your container. It's really easy. And I like easy. Next, I'm gonna secure the wicks so they don't like wobble around while I'm pouring the hot wax in. And I'm just gonna roll them onto some barbecue skewers. It's quite the apparatus I have going on here. I'm going to be making a Valentine's Day candle. And by Valentine's Day, I just mean I'm using red and white. That's Valentine's Day to me. Actually, chocolate is, but whatever. So I'm using just a regular candle. This one's been burnt down. It's really old, but still smells good. And then I have ones in glass jars. The ones in glass jars, you can just put in your hot water right away. That's no worries. But you can't do that with a pillar candle. So I have this, and it's for frothing milk when you're making lattes. Yeah, and we use it in our kitchen and I kind of just stole it and I've been using it for candles. So you just drop your pillar candle in here, like that. And then you put this into the hot water. So this is the color I'm gonna do first. So I just need to set up my hot water. My pot is about half full of water and I'm going to bring it to a really, really, really gentle boil. Just tiny little bubbles. I know this will take longer for the wax to melt, but if you use like, if you get your hot wax too hot when you pour it, then your finish will be like the wax will set really rough and uneven. So really low and just take your time. This is a nice weekend project. And I'm going to start with my wax already in the water. So I'm just going to put it in and then just turn it on boil. Now, once it starts boiling, I'm going to check on it and just kind of lower it till I get nice tiny little bubbles. So this part takes a while, but you just watch your wax just slowly start melting. And go have a coffee. Like, don't just stand around doing this. Just go have coffee. It's only been a couple of minutes and you can see the water's just gently boiling, tiny little bubbles, and the candle's already melting. So I'm going to let it melt just a little bit more so I can grab that burnt wick way down in there. Wax is melted and it's ready to be poured. It took, I would say it took less than 10 minutes on that low of heat to melt the wax. Well, not bad. And you don't have to feel rushed about any of this. This isn't a process that you have to feel that you have to get at a certain temperature or anything. No, it's nice. As long as it's liquidy, you can pour it. So don't feel rushed, take your time and enjoy the process. So this is just, it just looks like red water, and I'm gonna pour it, and I am a bit of a mess when I pour, but it ends up looking all right, so don't worry about that. I've secured, like I made sure these were nice and as taut as I could get them. My wicks are as taut as I could get them, and now I'm gonna pour. I am going to be layering this candle, and I can't do the next layer until this one is completely set. And you'll know your candle is set. There's nothing special about it. You just have to make sure it looks like what the original candle looked like. So it won't be shiny anymore. Like right now you can tell it's really shiny, and the color will be more of the original color. So it'll kind of just look more like a regular candle. I don't know how long it takes. I would say maybe an hour. I'm gonna give it an hour and then I'll come and check on it. At this point, your house is gonna smell so good. It just smells like you've been, it's just like a candle smell. It's awesome. So, okay, this guy's gonna set and then we'll do the next layer. My second layer is poured and now I have to wait. You don't wanna try rushing this part or like speeding it up by taking it outside to like in the cold to get it to set faster. Cause if you do that, your wax will set unevenly and you'll end up with a finish that doesn't look really professional. So just take your time and just relax. This is a nice relaxing project. While the candle's setting, let me show you a few ideas. First one, I filled this Starbucks coffee canister with coffee scented wax. And I just poured the last layer a couple minutes ago and the top is just setting. So I thought it'd be cute to add a few coffee beans on top. I picked up this glass candle holder at HomeSense and it gives me like really wintry vibes. I don't know if it makes it look like ice, but it just gives me wintry vibes. And I wanna have fun with this. I want to try and make a little wax snowflake to put on top. So I picked up these, like this is for making candies. It's just a silicone mold and I'm gonna pour wax inside one of these and see if then I can like take it out without breaking it and like fit it on top. I think that'll look so cute. So I'm gonna give it a try. Okay, we'll see what it looks like. I mean, if it totally fails, I just remelt everything and I make a simple candle. But I'm gonna try this, because they're cute. I mean. So my snowflake, it's set, like it's, I let it set overnight. So let's try taking it out. Seems pretty easy. I'm just being super, super careful. Oh, it's perfect. Aww. The hole didn't come all the way through. So I'm gonna pierce it just a little bit more. Super careful again. Oh, that's perfect. Oh my gosh, that's so cute. Okay. Now, I need to somehow secure this on. So, I have my embossing heat gun. I'm just gonna turn it on, melt a little bit of this wax up here. It melts really quick. Okay, that's enough. So that melted really quick. Ta-da! Look how cute that is. So this was from Michaels, and you can order them online for sure. I just ordered a bunch from Temu and I'm waiting for them to come in, but love it. Sometimes I buy candles just because I like the container they come in, like this cute little face. But I mean, I burned her down all the way. So instead of getting rid of this awesome cute little face, I'm just gonna melt down another pillar and pour it inside. So if you happen to have like just the candle that just perfectly matches your decor, but you've burnt it through, well, you can just keep reusing it. So I'm gonna melt this down and then pour it right in. I wanna try making a candle using a wood wick. I don't know much about wood wicks. I think I know two things. One, they make a nice sound usually, like sometimes it can kind of crackle, and you have to keep trimming them or else they, like when you use them, you have to trim them or else they burn out. So it's pretty much all I know. I ordered this one off Temu, and again, it's another, looks pretty thin, which seems to be my thing about wicks. I keep ordering thin wicks and whatever. But it comes with a nice little metal clip at the bottom, and my plan is, because it didn't come with stickers, and let's try this. I'm going to put my wood wick in, put a bit of wax, just a small, like a little layer of wax, let that set up, and then I'll pour the rest of the wax in. So I'll see if that holds the wood wick instead of using a sticker. So right now I have a pillar that's melting. It's a nice vanilla smelling pillar. And when it's melted down, I can make this. Now to finish off the Valentine's Day candle. I have some red wax melting and heart molds. Okay, how cute is it gonna be to have little hearts, like little red hearts, on top of my candle? I just have to pour the molds, let them set, and then using some heat, stick them to the candle. So now, what do you think about recycling old candles? I think it's the perfect project for hybrid baking in the winter. The wicks I sent out to my sister should be arriving any day now. So Maria, remember to send me pictures of the candles you make, okay? Well, before I go, here's a couple tips. Remember to trim your wick to a quarter inch and let your candle rest for about 7 days before lighting it. Also, remember to blow out your candle before going to bed. Oh, that's just a reminder for myself, for real. I need to remember that. If you enjoyed this video, rewatch it several times and share it with every single person you know. Okay, just kidding. But if you did that, it'd be so amazing for our channel. All right, thanks so much for watching. You're awesome. Maria, I miss you. And I'll see you all soon with another project. Bye. Now I'm gonna attempt to do this. Oh, by the way, I'm really mailing this. Got the wicks, got the envelope. This isn't just a prop. I'm really mailing this to her. And it's such a pretty card. Matches my shirt, totally by accident, but it's really cute. Okay, let's go gather some supplies. Did that even make sense? I don't, well, I can't get it out, so that's the way it's gonna be. Okay, no, I did get it out. Oh, sometimes I'm such a dork. Yep. I'm gonna go make myself a coffee. I feel like every video, I just then say, I'm gonna go and make myself a coffee. And pretty much every video I do just, it's like my treat. Yay, you did it, go make coffee. So I hope you go grab a coffee, or maybe you already grabbed a coffee and you're watching this video, just sitting there chilling with your coffee. Thank you so much, I totally appreciate it. Bye.